हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. इन कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ बॉन्ड स्ट्रक्चर एंड बॉन्डिंग लेक्चर 3, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बॉन्ड एंगल्स एंड बॉन्ड एनर्जी. बॉन्ड एंगल्स. पॉलीएटॉमिक मॉलिक्यूल कंटेन्स मोर देन द वन कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड. ईच कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बाय ओवरलैप ऑफ एटॉमिक और हाइब्रिड ऑर्बिटल्स. Since atomic orbitals except s orbital, p, d or f are directional in nature, because s orbital is sphere in shape, so it does not have any direction. Therefore, covalent bonds make angles between them. Thus, the angle between any two adjacent covalent bonds in a polyatomic molecule is called the bond angles. Bond angle depends upon the following two factors: the number of shared and lone pairs of electrons around the central atom in a molecule. For example, CH4, NH3, and H2O. See here. In CH4 methane molecule, carbon hydrogen bond angle means all four having bond angle 109.28. It is tetrahedral, so its bond angle is higher compared to this ammonia. In ammonia, H bond angle is lower because it having two lone pair of electrons, whereas in water it is lower compared to ammonia and methane. Here four unpaired of electrons, it is its bond angle is 104.5 degree. Second factor, it depends on the type of hybridization. In ethene molecule, because it contain one sigma bond and second is pi bond, so pi bond electrons are delocalizing, so it repel the bond, so its bond angle is higher compared to methane. Similarly, here in benzene, it is higher. Bond angle is higher. It is 120 degree. In acetylene, carbon-carbon triple bond, it is more higher. It is about 180 degree. So this is due to the reason that pi electrons being less tightly held by the carbon atoms repel the bond pair of carbon hydrogen bonds more than bond pairs of the carbon hydrogen bond repel each other. Third point is bond energy. Whenever covalent bond is formed, some amount of energy is always released. Conversely, the same amount of energy will require to break the bond. There are two kinds of bond energy: bond dissociation energy and bond energy. Bond dissociation energy, the amount of energy required to break one mole of hydrogen molecule into individual atoms is 104 kilocalorie per mole. See here, hydrogen molecule, when it is break into hydrogen, it is its energy is required is 104 kilocalorie per mole, so it is called bond dissociation energy. Bond energy means when complete molecule is dissociate. For example, water molecule when it is dissociate hydrogen to hydroxy, and then hydroxy is dissociated into oxygen and hydrogen. So in first step it is 118 kilocalorie per mole, and second step its energy dissociation means energy is 100 kilocalorie per mole. So average bond energy is 109 kilocalorie per mole. Similarly, in methane molecule, bond energy D1 bond energy it is 102 kilocalorie per mole, and when D2 when CH3 molecule is dissociated into CH2 plus H, it is 105 kilocalorie per mole. CH2 to CH plus hydrogen 108 kilocalorie per mole, whereas carbon hydrogen into carbon plus hydrogen D4 is 83 kilocalorie per mole. So total average energy, bond energy, is D1 plus D2 plus D3 plus D4 divided by 4. So it will come around 398 upon 4. It is 99.5 kilocalorie per mole. So bond energy depends upon the following factor: size of the atom. See here, as the size of the atom is increases, bond dissociation energy is decreasing, because the when distance is increases, it is easy to break the bond. So for here, carbon fluorine bond distance is less, bond length is less, but its bond dissociation energy is more. So whereas in carbon iodine, bond distance is more, but its bond dissociation energy is less. So this is again depend on the size of the atom. As the size of the atom forming covalent bond increases, bond length increases, but bond energy is decreasing. Second factor, multiplicity of the bond. As the multiplicity of the bond increases, the bond length decreases, and hence the bond energy increases. See here, carbon-carbon single bond, it having bond distance is more, as we know, 1.54, but its bond energy is 83, whereas carbon-carbon double bond, 146, its bond length is 1.34, whereas carbon triple bond, as we know, its bond length is 1.20 angstrom, but its bond dissociation energy is 199. It depends on the type of hybridization. What type of hybridization is there? See here, in sp3 hybridized carbon attached hydrogen, its bond dissociation energy is 99.5, whereas sp2 hybridized carbon hydrogen bond dissociation energy is higher, 105, whereas in sp carbon hydrogen it's 121.3. similarly, see here, one sp3, because p orbital, as we earlier also I told you that p orbital is bigger in size compared to s orbital, so here size of the orbital is increases, but due to the distance is increases, so but bond dissociation energy is decreasing. Shorter bonds are stronger bonds, as we have seen that increasing S character shortens the bond. It follows that bond strength increases with increasing S character. Second factor, double bonds are both shorter and stronger than the corresponding single bonds, but bond energy is not twice because of pi electrons. Sigma bond is stronger than the pi electron bond. See here, let me repeat the things. See here, कार्बन कार्बन सिंगल बॉन्ड, इट हैविंग 83 किलो कैलोरी पर मोल. सो नेचुरली कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड, इट्स डिसोसिएशन एनर्जी शुड बी 166 किलो कैलोरी पर मोल. बट इट इज नॉट 166, इट इज 146, इट इज लेस. सिमिलरली इन कार्बन ट्रिपल बॉन्ड, कार्बन इट्स बॉन्ड डिसोसिएशन एनर्जी इज 199, बट इट शुड बी थियोरिटिकली कैलकुलेट, इट शुड बी 259, बट इट इज लेस. सो दिस इज बिकॉज पाई इलेक्ट्रॉन पाई बॉन्ड इज वीक बॉन्ड एंड इट इज लूजली हेल्ड. सो एंड सिग्मा बॉन्ड इज स्ट्रांग. सो ड्यू टू दिस रीजन इट इज नॉट अ मल्टीप्लाई. Thank you very much for today's lecture.